Online money just like ran out the equation to buy it.
I normally don't want to divide them, I just...
You just look at it.
I just say one of them is the whole one.
All right, let's get started. Welcome to class today. Let's start with a prayer. All right, so let's see. Next one, I need four.
Dear Father, thank you so much for this wonderful day that we have to be at this wonderful campus and to learn more about the world of physics. Heavenly Father, please bless us with the Spirit that might be able to understand these principles of the world around us to better understand them. Heavenly Father, please bless our professor, Professor Chesnel, that she might be able to teach us that we might be able to understand. Thank you so much for all the opportunities that you've given us to receive higher education. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Thank you. All right, so today I thought we could celebrate something. Is it just
what? What is it?
October 3rd, right? Any birthdays today? My
birthday.
Who?
My mom.
Oh, your mom's birthday? Happy birthday to your mom. So, but something related to physics. Nobel Prizes. Last night they announced the Nobel Prize for Physics. Awarded to three people: Arthur Ashkin from USA, Gérard Mouron from France, and then Donna Strickland from Canada. Which is remarkable because she's a woman
and only the
third one receiving a Nobel Prize in Physics since the history of the world. First one was Marie Curie, and then Maria Goodberg, and then Donna Strickland from Canada. So that's great. And for their work, I'm sure there will be in the coming days lots of news about that, but groundbreaking invention in the field of laser physics and pulse laser physics. So, I don't know if some of you have started research with any of the faculty members here, but some of our faculty members here in the department also work in that field. Anyway, so let's move on then to our class and talk about what we'll be doing. So, on Monday, we kind of started like this activity, you know, the 5G activity, so the atomic energy level. So my goal today is to start with that, so we complete that, and then we'll have a presentation on the application of spectroscopy in astronomy, so by Emma and Ryan. Where is Ryan? So we have a presentation already on the slide. And then we talk about the Bohr's model of energy levels. Okay, so let's go back to our activity. And in a minute, I'm going to wait in a second. But if everyone is in the darkness, we go to the complete darkness. So first, maybe before I do that, make sure you grab your sheet here, the activity sheet. Anyone needs that? Anyone need that?
Yeah, math.
Yeah. Make sure you have all the way to your side. You are ready? Can I turn off the lights? Kinama?
So what does it mean by spectral line?
Spectral lines, so where is that line?
Like in part two?
Yeah.
It doesn't mean like how many individual lines?
Yes, that's what it means.
The lines of human sex.
So like down in neon, all, I don't know which one you're on.
Yeah, all those lines, all those individual lines. Okay, so are you ready? I'm going to turn off the lights. Quickly, Abby, so grab a grating, I'm going to turn off the lights. Get a seat. And so here we go. So one of the questions, remember, is going to be about how many lines you observe for hydrogen. So put the question in front of your eye, in the proper direction, so it's scattered in the horizontal direction. Looks like, maybe I should turn off the computer so there is no